Now, in addition to being a great field recorder, the Zoom F3 can also be used as an audio interface for your phone, tablet, computer. But in this video, we'll only be demonstrating how to connect it to your computer. The steps are basically the same for mobile devices. You can find more info about that in the F3 user guide. What's an audio interface? In this case, it allows you to use your F3 as the audio hub for your computer. You can connect mics to your F3 and record to your computer, and you can plug headphones into your F3 and listen to the sound of your computer through the F3 itself. Now, before we start, there are a couple of things you need to note here. Just take note of those in case you're using one of these scenarios. First, plug a USB-C cable, make sure it is in fact a data cable, into the F3's USB port. Then plug the other end into the computer. Now, we need to put the F3 into audio interface mode. So go into the main menu and scroll down to USB Audio IF. Select that option, then specify whether you're connecting to a PC or Mac or a tablet or phone. Then you choose whether you want to be in linear or float mode. So if you're going to use this for Zoom calls or live streaming, 24-bit linear is the right choice for you. Choose 32-bit float mode if you'll be recording really, really loud, unpredictable singing, screaming, laughing. So it can be useful for boisterous podcasts, for example, or very loud sound effects. For our general purposes, we'll choose 24-bit mode. After you make that selection, you'll be returned to the main monitoring screen, and the F3 is ready to go. Lastly, we need to make sure the routing is correct on your computer. In macOS, this means going into the system settings, audio, and choosing the Zoom audio device as both our output and our input. Then in our digital audio workstation or recording software, we'll also want to open the audio preferences and choose the F3. Again, it usually appears as something like Zoom audio device as both our input and our output device. Yes, you need to set them in both the digital audio workstation and in the operating system to ensure that audio flows correctly throughout the entire system. If you want to confirm that the F3 is in 32-bit float mode on macOS, you can also pull up the Audio MIDI Setup app. Again, select Zoom audio device and make sure that it's registering as a 2-in, 2-out device at 48 kHz with two channels and 32-bit float enabled. Now, if you set it up at 24-bit, it'll show 24-bit linear instead. Now, the F3 is ready to be used with your computer as an audio interface. Let's try a test recording with our F3 set up as an audio interface directly into our DAW or recording app on the computer.
All right, this is a test recording using the Zoom F3 as our audio interface. So I've got my Shure SM58. That's what I'm talking into. That's routed into input 1 on the Zoom F3. As you can see, we've got our levels right there. And then that is routed through the F3 into my MacBook, and that's what you're seeing in the screen recording right here, and we're recording directly into Logic. So you're going to hear this unprocessed sample. We do have a light going. You might hear the fan. We have a chest freezer in the corner that's also running, so there might be some noise. But otherwise, this is completely unprocessed, and this is what you can expect to get, routing microphones through the F3 in audio interface mode directly into a DAW on your computer.
And that's how you set up the Zoom F3 with your computer as an audio interface. If you need the basics on how to set up your F3 to record with microphones and set the input levels, have a look at our quick setup guide, which we left a link for down below. In the meantime, get out there and make some great sound. Talk to you soon.